this day our daily bread. As we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil one.
Let thy mercy, O Lord, be upon us as we have hoped on thee.
Wisdom. casting a net into the sea, for they were fishermen. Then he said to them, "Follow me, and I will make you fishers of men." They immediately left their nets and followed him. Going on from there, he saw two other brothers, James the son of Zebedee and John his brother, in the boat with Zebedee their father, mending their nets. He called them, and immediately they left the boat and their father and followed him. And Jesus went about all Galilee, teaching in their synagogues, preaching the gospel of the kingdom, and healing all kinds of sickness and all kinds of disease among the people. Given him. and he would pray for them, and he would teach them the faith of the Orthodox Church, of the gospel of Christ, not only in his words, because he never learned the native languages, he only spoke Russian, but yet he was able to communicate to the native-speaking people this gospel of Christ through his kindness, through the grace of the Holy Spirit that radiated from him through his ascetical toils and through his holy life. So he, amongst all of the North American saints, and again, that number is growing, more and more saints of the American continent are being canonized, especially of the 20th century. There are few that are sort of on the docket, so to speak, who will probably be canonized by God's grace in the next few years. But even more than them are those who have shown forth that we do not have icons of. As I said last week, of all saints, those who have shown forth who we do not know, only God knows their name, and only God knows the holiness that has dwelt in them, his holiness. And our North American saints have faced many, many things. St. Herman, as I just said, that was one of many things he faced that was not of the church, that was of society. And he spoke the truth to that society, both of what is right, what is correct according to the gospel, and what is missing the mark when it comes to the gospel. Just like those before him, all the saints before him have had their time in society where they're certainly not accepted, but certainly speak the truth to that society that they find themselves in. So we have in the American society many things that we are dealing with, as with any society, and we have many things that divide us and many things that tear us apart and cause turmoil. And there are many things that, not too many things, that bring us peace as a people, for Jesus Christ alone is our peace. We had something that has been very divisive and continues now to be very divisive in our land, the Roe v. Wade overturning last Friday, sending the issue of abortion back to the states to decide on what is good for each and every state. So how would the North American saints react to that? What would be their response to that? To something that's divisive in their time? Something that maybe causes people pain, causes people anguish, causes people not to see Christ, causes people maybe to reject Christ in their frustration? Well, the North American saints, God forgive me, I will assume, would show mercy and grace to each and every person they encounter. They would show mercy and grace to those with whom they disagree. They would show mercy and grace to those who enter into sin. They would show forgiveness to them. They would embrace them, not their sin, but their humanity. And they would try to lead them with love, with conviction, with determination and confidence in the cross of our Lord and the resurrection to Christ, so that they may have his peace and his joy and his life more abundantly. That they would show the path of forgiveness to Christ, first and foremost by following it themselves, by going to confession, by repenting. But in the issue of taking another human's life, in whatever capacity it may be, forgiveness should be sought by those who have partaken in that behavior. And the saints with love would guide them to that, and that is our call, brothers and sisters, as well. Second thing, as witnessed not only by St. Herman, but all of the saints in their own particular way, St. Jacob of Alaska especially, miraculous story to read, they would help the less fortunate. They would be present for those women who find themselves in very difficult circumstances, who find themselves possibly without a home, without hope, without Christ, without food, without a future. They would be there. They would corral the resources of their local area and help them. And thank God the Orthodox Church has done and continues to do that to help not only those facing pregnancies or who are pregnant, but also helping all those who are in need as best she possibly can. But now perhaps we have to do more, brothers and sisters. And I was thinking about this yesterday and Friday, praying about it. What exactly do we do as a parish to help those who are facing difficult times through unexpected pregnancy? And I would say, dare say, other than praying for them, which is very important, I don't think we do anything. So maybe we need to get a committee together as a parish and start finding resources and networking with other places, not reinventing the wheel. There are a lot of resources available. But being sort of the guideposts, the beacons of light, you could say, here, my dear, here's where you can get help. Or if you need to stay somewhere for the night because you were kicked out of your home or you're in some circumstance, you find yourself that you don't know where to go, we'll take care of you as the body of Christ. I think that's something we should do, brothers and sisters. As Christians, we have to walk the walk. We're going to talk the talk, no matter the issue. And on this issue, the Orthodox talk a lot, and they don't walk very much to show the gospel in action, to fulfill the law of Christ, the law of love. So we show mercy and grace, we help the less fortunate, and the third and final thing that we do, brothers and sisters, is what is proper to us, is to work out our own salvation through ascetical life, to ascend to Christ in our life, to fast, to pray for the world, which we do every liturgy. We pray for everything, multiple times, multiple petitions. We pray for peace, we pray for the world, the president, the civil authorities, the armed forces, the bishops, the sick, the dying, the dead, everybody, multiple times. To continue to work out our salvation so that just like the North American saints, somehow by God's grace, if God wills it, that His Holy Spirit radiates from us and brings others to Christ. As St. Seraphim has so eloquently said, is paraphrased a million different ways, but if we acquire the grace of the Holy Spirit ourselves, 1,000 around us will be saved. To be those beacons. Not to shout at people and argue with people, but to show the silent love of Christ, the light of Christ, because somehow that's happening within our own life because we're serious about our relationship with Christ. Only by being in this life can we bring others to it, to bring others to repentance, to bring others to grace, to show mercy, to bring others to Christ. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is the salvation of the world. He was incarnate, crucified, and resurrected so that we may have life eternally and more abundantly. Let us glorify and worship Him in these ways by reaching out, emulating our saintly family, the North American family, emulating their way, living in the Holy Spirit, and meeting those people who have needs where they're at, and bringing them to Christ and fulfilling the law of love. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Christ is in our midst.
Yes, in our midst.
Let us say, O Lord, our soul, our mind, let us say,
when
we're
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
diaconate in Christ, all the clergy and the people, those who love us and those who hate us, together with those who have no one to pray for them, the sick and the suffering we are praying for this day, together with those who have fallen asleep in hope of eternal rest, may the Lord God remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. President of this nation, its civil authorities, and those serving in its armed forces, especially those serving in harm's way, may the Lord God remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For you and all Orthodox Christians, may the Lord God remember you in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages.
Oh.
bless these graves, these give thanks to thee, and to worship thee in every place of thy dominion. For thou art God, ineffable, inconceivable, invisible, incomprehensible, ever existing, and eternally the same. Thou and thine only begotten Son, thy Holy Spirit, thou who loves to brought us from thy existence into being. And when we have fallen away, didst raise us up again, and didst thou cease to do all things, until thou hast brought us up to heaven, and hast endowed us with thy kingdom which is to come. For all these things we give thanks to thee, to thy only begotten Son, and to thy Holy Spirit, for all things in which we Spirit upon us and among these gifts you offer, and make this bread to be the precious body of thy Christ.
Amen.
And that which is in this cup to be the precious blood of thy Christ.
Amen.
Thank you.
life everlasting. Amen.
Thank you.
your mother, through the supplications of the all laudable apostles, of the first enthroned of the apostles Peter and Paul, patrons of this holy church, of our father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, whose liturgy we have celebrated on this day, through the intercessions of all saints of America, whom we commemorate on this day, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us for as much as he is good and loves mankind. Christ is in our midst.
Yes.
God bless all of you. Good morning. A few announcements, reminders about our schedule for the parish council members and anyone who'd like to join us. Tomorrow evening we have a meeting at 7 p.m. on Zoom. The link is in the bulletin for those who would like to join us. This a reminder that as we're in the midst of this short Apostles' Fast, that the ending of that fast period is our feast day of St. Peter and Paul, which we'll celebrate Vespers in Lycia Tuesday evening at 6:30, and then Divine Liturgy on Wednesday at 9:30 a.m. So we'll have local clergy and faithful from other parishes are joining us for that as well, for both services. Please make note of that. And then lastly, the list of icons is shrinking a bit in the bulletin. If you're interested in any kind of sponsorship of those icons, please see me, let me know, and we'll figure something out. And lastly, we'll sing many years to our birthdays, and about this week, we'll sing many years too. So may God bless all of you. 11:05, that's not bad with no deacon, so I'm getting out of here at a good time. May God bless all of you. Christ is in our midst.
Amen.